Thank you. The remaining nominees for the election of the Deputy Presiding Officer are Annabel Ewing, Rhoda Grant and Liam MacArthur. The voting period is now open, using the same voting procedure as before. I ask that members please put on their face coverings while the clerks distribute the ballot papers and for the duration of the voting period. Thank you. Voting for this round of the Deputy Presiding Officer election is closed, and I would now invite the scrutineers to proceed to P102 for the counting of votes. Thank you. In this round of voting in the election of the Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. Annabel Ewing, 64. Rhoda Grant, 16. Liam MacArthur, 44. There was one abstention, no spoilt ballots. Accordingly, as Annabel Ewing received more votes than the total number of votes received by the other candidates, and as more than 25% of members voted, Annabel Ewing is elected as Deputy Presiding Officer. My congratulations, Ms. Ewing. I'm looking forward to working with you. Now, as members may know, I have selected three urgent questions for this afternoon. These will follow a brief suspension at the end of the election of the Deputy Presiding Officers. And when we get to that item, if you do wish to ask a supplementary question and you're either in the main hall or public gallery, you should raise your hand when the relevant question is asked. And the clerk will then convey your request to me and will direct you to a part of your location from where you would be able to ask your question if called. Okay. I believe that Daniel Johnson would like a point of order.
Indeed. Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I'm grateful for taking this point of order. I think we all recognise the huge importance of the election of the Deputy Presiding Officers, but I think quite a considerable amount of time has been taken, probably twice as much as any of us might have expected this process to take. Can I therefore ask you to consider bringing forward a motion under Rule 17.2 in consultation with the Parliamentary Bureau to vary standing orders, in particular under Rule 11.9, subsections 9 and 10, so that we can substitute the mechanism currently in place with the use of the single transferable vote, which is a method far more suited to an election of this sort and would be far more efficient. I'd be very grateful if you and the Bureau could give consideration to this.
Okay. I thank Mr. Johnson for his point of order. I will not bring forward such a motion today. I'm sure he would agree that it would be potentially unfair and inappropriate to change the election method halfway through, but I would certainly agree that this can be considered ahead of the next such election. Thank you. We're going to have a 5-minute period. Thank you. We're going to have a 5-minute period during which candidates may notify clerks should they wish to withdraw, because we're now going to move on to, well, we will, after that 5-minute period, move on to the election of the second Deputy Presiding Officer. But I'm going to allow 5 minutes should any candidate wish to notify clerks of an intention to withdraw. Thank you. Thank you. The candidates for the election of the second Deputy Presiding Officer are Claire Adamson, Claire Baker, Jeremy Balfour, James Dornan, Rhoda Grant, Liam MacArthur, Stuart McMillan and Edward Mountain. Bill Kidd has withdrawn from this election. Voting rounds will now begin for the second Deputy Presiding Officer, involving all candidates who were unsuccessful in the election of the first Deputy Presiding Officer, as I have just described. And there will now be a short break while ballot papers are printed, so we'll have another 5-minute suspension. Thank you. The voting period is now open. Using the same voting procedure as before, I would ask that members please put on their face coverings while the clerks distribute the ballot papers and for the duration of the voting period. Thank you. Voting for this round of the presiding officer election is now closed. The clerks will now take the ballot boxes to P102, and I'd invite any scrutineers appointed by the candidates to make their way to P102 to observe the counting of ballot papers while observing social distancing. Thank you. In this round of voting in the election of the second Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. Claire Adamson, 10. Claire Baker, 13. Jeremy Balfour, 5. James Dornan, 9. Rhoda Grant, 10. Liam MacArthur, 45. Stuart McMillan, 20. Edward Mountain, 12. And I have been notified that Mr Mountain intends to withdraw from the next round of voting. Oh yes, I should say of course that there were no abstentions and no spoiled ballots, and that the candidate eliminated from this round is Jeremy Balfour. A further voting round will now begin for the election of the second Deputy Presiding Officer, and there will be a short break while ballot papers are printed, and I suspend this meeting. Thank you. The voting period is now open. Using the same voting procedure as before, I ask that members please put on their face coverings while the clerks distribute the ballot papers and for the duration of the voting period. Voting for this round of the Deputy Presiding Officer election is now closed. The clerks will now take the ballot boxes to P102, and I would invite any scrutineers appointed by the candidates to make their way to P102 to observe the counting of ballot papers while observing social distancing.
Thank you. Exactly. A poet.
I think they come in the morning.
Thank you. In this round of voting, in the election of the second Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. Claire Adamson, 7. Claire Baker, 9. James Dornan, 5. Rhoda Grant, 9. Liam MacArthur, 74. Stuart McMillan, 19. There were no abstentions and there were no spoiled ballots. Accordingly, as Liam MacArthur received more votes than the total number of votes received by the other candidates, and as more than 25% of members voted, Liam MacArthur is elected as the second Deputy Presiding Officer of the Scottish Parliament, and I very much look forward to working with him. I would also at this point like to thank each and every candidate who took part in this election. As you may be aware, we will have an urgent questions session this afternoon, and I would suggest that we suspend from now until 4 p.m. when we will move to urgent questions. Thank you. I suspend.